Salam everyone. Today I'm going to explain Mathematical Induction Principle. So before starting, I would like to explain where we use Mathematical Induction Principle. So basically, Mathematical Induction Principle is used to prove a mathematical statement in general form. What is mathematical statement in general form? When an equation, a mathematical equation involving n terms or nth power of a term is called a general statement. For example, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 is a particular statement. This is not a general statement because there are not n number of terms in the statement. While if we talk about the statement 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on to n is equal to n plus 1 upon 2. So this is a general statement, and here we need to use mathematical induction principle. So now let us talk about mathematical induction principle. Basically, mathematical induction principle states that a mathematical expression or mathematical statement, say Pn, is true for all n belongs to natural numbers. If P1 is true and Pr plus 1 is true, if Pr is true. Suppose we need to prove 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to n square is equal to n plus 1 to n plus 1 upon 6. So this is a mathematical statement in general form because there are n terms involved in this statement. So we need to prove this with the help of mathematical induction principle. So first step is to assume the statement as Pn. So let the Pn be the statement is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to n square is equal to n plus 1 to n plus 1 upon 6. That will be equation number 1. So according to mathematical induction principle, we need to prove first P1 is true. Then assuming Pr is true, we need to prove Pr plus 1 is also true whenever Pr is true. So first step, P1, we have to check. So P1 means we have to replace n by 1 in this statement. So obviously n means the number of terms. So when n is equal to 1, we have to take only one term from the left hand side. So on the left hand side, we get 1 square is equal to, on the right hand side, we have to replace n by 1. So we have 1 plus 1 and 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 2 plus 1 upon 6. Simplifying, we have 1 into 2 into 3 upon 6, which is equal to 6 upon 6, and that is equal to 1. So finally, we get 1 square is equal to 1, which is absolutely true. Which is true. So we have shown that P1 is true. So first condition of mathematical induction principle is satisfied. Now we have to assume that Pr is true. Let Pr is true. So if Pr is true, first we write the statement Pr, that means replacing n by r in this expression. We have 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to r square. Replacing n by r on right hand side, we have r plus 1 to r plus 1 upon 6. Let it be question number 2. Now we have to prove that if PR is true, PR plus 1 is also true. So let us write what will be the statement PR plus 1 replacing R by R plus 1. In this expression we get 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to R plus 1 whole square is equal to R plus 1. If we replace R by R plus 1 in this bracket we get R plus 2, and if we replace R plus 1 here we get 2R plus 1 plus 1 upon 6. Further simplifying this expression, on right hand side we get R plus 1, R plus 2, and if we open up this bracket it will be 2R plus 2 plus 1. So 2R plus 3 upon 6. So if we can prove PR plus 1 is equal to 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square so on to R plus 1 square is equal to R plus 1 R plus 2 2R plus 3 upon 6, we would then PR plus 1 will be true. So we need to prove this statement, and for that purpose we have to add R plus 1 square on both sides of equation number 2, because PR we have assumed as a true statement. So adding R plus 1 whole square on both sides of equation 2, we get on left hand side we have 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to R square, and after that we have added R plus 1 whole square on left hand side, and now the same expression we have to add on right hand side, because adding the same expression on same number on both sides of an equation is a permissive operation. So R plus 1 2R plus 1 upon 6 plus R plus 1 whole square. So initially left hand side we get the same as that of PR plus 1, so we need not to do anything on left hand side, simply write down as it is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on to write down the last term, which is R plus 1 whole square. On the right hand side, on simplifying this expression, we have to show that the value of this expression is exactly equal to this, then PR plus 1 will be true. So simplifying this, R plus 1 is common out of these two terms. So R plus 1 taken common, we get in the first term R 2R plus 1. This term and this expression, these two expressions in numerator and in denominator 6, and here because we have taken 1 power of R plus 1 common, so here 1 power is left R plus. Further simplifying the right hand side, we have R plus 1, and within the bracket we may take 6 LCM. In numerator we get here 2R square plus R into 1R plus and 6 R plus 6. Continuing from this step, R plus 1, and here simplifying this expression we get 2 R square and 6 R plus R 7 R plus 6 upon 6. Now further simplifying this, R plus 1 as it is, and here we have to factorize the numerator. For that purpose we have to write down 2 R square, and 7 R may be written as 4R plus 3R and plus 6 as it is upon 6. Now R plus 1 as it is, out of these two terms 2r is common. 2r is common. So 2r we have taken common. What is left inside r plus 2? Here r is left because 2r we have taken common, and if we divide 4r plus 2r, we get only 2. From the next two terms, 3 is common obviously. So 3 is common, and in the bracket we get r plus 2 divided by 6. Now r plus 1 as it is. Out of these two terms, r plus 2 is common. So taking r plus 2 common, in the first term we get 2r, in the second term we get plus 3 upon 6. So finally we get the same expression on the right hand side as in the right hand side of p r plus 1. So on the left hand side we are proceeding from here. R1 is square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to r plus 1. That is the same left hand side of p r plus 1, and at last we get on the right hand side r plus 1, r plus 2, 2r plus 3 upon 6. The same right hand side as that of p r plus 1. So ultimately we may conclude that p r plus 1 is also true if p r is true. So p r plus 1 is true if p r is true. So both the criterion we have proved of mathematical induction principle. We have shown p1 is true for the given statement, and p r plus 1 is true whenever p r is true. So by mathematical induction principle we may conclude that we may conclude that Pn is true for all n belongs to natural number. Hence 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus so on to n square is equal to n plus 1 2n plus 1 upon 6, and that's it.